Thanks to the cloud, you can store your data on demand on remote infrastructures, hosted and managed by a cloud provider, such as AWS, Microsoft Azure, or Google Cloud. Regardless of the cloud provider, there are three types of storage: block storage, file storage, and object storage. Each type of storage allows for the preservation, organization, and presentation of data in different ways, each with its own strengths, limitations, and specificities, catering to specific use cases. Understanding all this is crucial for choosing the storage that best fits your needs. Businesses often require multiple types of storage based on data usage and the nature of the data itself. Let's start with block storage. In the cloud, block storage is seen as disk space for instances where they can store their data. It's comparable to employing block storage as an exclusive disk for your virtual machine. Examples of block storage offerings include AWS EBS for elastic block storage, Azure Disk Storage, and Google Cloud Persistent Disk. With block storage, a file is divided into multiple data blocks, hence its name, and stored separately. Each block exists independently, allowing the storage system to keep small blocks in the most convenient location. This enables updating specific segments finely, improving performance for applications requiring low latency and executing numerous transactions. A limitation of block storage is its association with a specific instance. Volumes are only accessible via an operating system. When a specific file is needed by the operating system of an instance, the underlying storage system software reassembles the data blocks. It then presents them in a manner similar to a hard drive. Technically, block storage is generally deployed in storage area network environments where data blocks are distributed across storage bays via a dedicated network. Now let's see file storage. File storage is a file sharing solution that presents files to both applications and end users. Data is stored as elements within folders, accessible via a hierarchical path through folders and subfolders. This hierarchical structure is typical of network-attached storage. Examples of file storage offerings include AWS EFS for elastic file storage, Azure Files, and Google Cloud File Store. A file system controls file access, sharing, and protection, including password protection. Common uses of file storage include content repositories, facilitating document collaboration and sharing within an organization. File systems can be accessed simultaneously and shared by multiple instances, essential for multi-server application environments. While file storage is efficient with a moderate number of files, its hierarchical structure can become limiting with a large volume of files. Getting files becomes harder and takes more time, and file storage systems are not as easily scalable. The last one is object storage. Object storage is ideal for storing large volumes of unstructured data, such as videos, images, static web pages, text, audio files, emails, etc. Unstructured data doesn't conform to predefined models as seen in relational databases, hence the term non-structured. Cloud providers' object storage offerings include AWS S3 for simple storage service, Azure Blob Storage, and Google Cloud Storage. Objects contain the data itself, metadata, for example, video recording locations and actors, and a unique object identifier. Objects are stored in buckets, which are modular units often distributed across storage infrastructures. Object storage offers direct data access via APIs, making data accessible from web applications on any device simultaneously. Compared to the other two types, object storage is the most scalable, rapidly scaling to petabytes of data at a competitive price. Its extensive use of metadata makes data retrieval more straightforward. However, objects cannot be modified. You must create a new object for any changes. It is well suited for static data, making it popular for backup, archiving, and static websites. Thanks to metadata and its ability to handle large data volumes, object storage is ideal for big data, artificial intelligence, and data analysis use cases. Thank you for watching this video on storage until the end. Feel free to share it with anyone who might need a better understanding of the subject. Don't forget to subscribe to not miss any upcoming videos. and see you soon.